Hopefully you can see me and hear me okay. Well, lately I've had a migraine for 4 days now, off and on. My neck hurts, I have a knot in it. Just been stressed. Just a lot going on. Last month was horrible. I don't like fighting or any of that. Last month was way too much that going on. So, any of my family members or friends, whatnot, like to fight and argue, I no longer have them in my life. Because I'm not going to go through all that stress. I can't handle stress, especially with my illness with sarcoidosis. It's very hard on me. It wears me out mentally, physically. I still haven't got enough rest from last month. And just a lot going on this month already too. Just feeling lost, depressed, and can't see my psychiatrist because coronavirus. Can't see none of my doctors and have my thyroid tested and get my liver tested to make sure it's still working. I've just been very fatigued. Eventually I'll get enough rest. Who knows? Maybe I won't. Just a lot going on. And my health, you know, with sarcoidosis, we go through a lot. And stress isn't good for even a healthy person, but it's really not good for us. Fighting a lot can end up taking our life. You know, it's very hard. And I kicked out my ex from fighting all the time. I'm not going to talk about that relationship, but it was just an example. I have anxiety and depression and PTSD, mostly because of that relationship. I also have anxiety because how people are when you go out. I'm just assuming that you're big from eating a lot. Well, there's doctors that assume that too when they look at us. When our weight is from prednisone. It's all water weight. I'm finally losing my water weight. It's taken a while, but it's going slowly. And because of the prednisone, I have problems with my thyroid. I have hyperactive thyroid now. I never had problems with my thyroid before until being on prednisone. So, just been super sore. My ankles and my knees have been hurting really bad. Trying to get stuff situated and organized. And hopefully, you know, my health is a little bit better than what it was last year. I still have rough days where it's hard for me to do dishes, vacuum, doing laundry, any of that. It's very hard on me. Scared of my health getting really bad and having to go in a nursing home. Even though I've had family say that won't happen, they'll take care of me. But you know, most of the time, when it actually comes down to it, that's not probably going to happen. But also, I don't think I'd want them to take care of me. Because I don't want to be that family member. The one that ends up being a burden. But I also don't want to be in a nursing home where I get beat or murdered, whatever. I think about this stuff and death a lot. But sarcoidosis sucks. And if you're feeling lost and depressed, trust you're not alone. And if you need someone to talk to, you can find me on YouTube or even Facebook. Just send me a message. And I'll be there. This illness is scary, and it's really scary when you're in a dark place and you have no one to talk to. I lost a very close friend to me, but she was like a little sister from suicide. And I do believe everything happens for a reason. I've talked to people that, you know, were thinking about suicide and got them to change their mind. Just think of it this way. All the pain you're feeling, I know you're not thinking about that you may go to hell or whatever. Most of the time you're just thinking about, you just want the pain to go away. You don't want to deal with it anymore. You've been strong for too long. And you're just done. And you might also think that your family and friends are better off without you. I've been there. I've thought that. All of those. But let me tell you this. All that pain that you're feeling right now, double it by the thousands. Then double it again to the trillions. That's the pain your family and friends will feel until the day they die. That pain of you committing suicide, it doesn't go away. It doesn't get better with time. That pain actually grows with time. And I know. Because there's not a second, not a minute or hour, day, month, week, whatever, year that goes by, that I don't miss talking to my friend, hearing her voice, hearing her laugh. And I don't get to hear that no more. The only time I get to talk to her is when I pray. And then even then, I don't get to hear her talk back. So just keep that in mind. And hopefully your day is pain-free. And stay safe from COVID. And I pray that you and your family stay safe from that. And God bless you guys. Bye.